بسم الله والحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا رسول الله. We start with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All praise is due to Him. And we ask Allah ta'ala to raise the rank of our Prophet Muhammad and to protect his nation from that which he fears for them. Brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, I will be talking briefly about the second best prophet, who is Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. His story is mentioned repeatedly in the Holy Quran in number of surah. There is a surah in the Holy Quran named Surah Ibrahim alayhi salam. First of all, let it be known that all the prophets of Allah, starting from Prophet Adam alayhi salam and ending with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, came with one creed. No one is God except Allah. No one deserves to be worshipped except Allah. They all came with one religion, which is Al-Islam. Al-Islam is the religion of all the prophets, of all the messengers. So the first of the prophets is Prophet Adam alayhi salam, who lived in paradise for a while, 130 years he lived in paradise. And he lived on earth 870 years, totaling 1,000 years. And the second best prophet, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, was also Muslim and came with one creed, with one aqeedah, as Prophet Adam alayhi salam came with and as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam came with, which is the religion of Al-Islam. Same belief, same aqeedah. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Al-Anbiya ikhwatun li'allat, deenuhum wahid wa ummahatuhum shatta. What is the meaning of the hadith ikhwatun li'allat? The prophets are brothers from the same father. The meaning of ikhwa li'allat, from the same father, who is Prophet Adam alayhi salam. Wa ummahatuhum, it refers to the shara'i', set of rules and laws which they received. Shatta, differed. This is referring to their belief is one, and their shara'i' differed. وَأُمَّهَاتُهُمْ شَتَّى. Then the Prophet said, وَأَنَا أَوْلَى النَّاسِ بِعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمْ لَيْسَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَهُ نَبِيٌّ. وَأَنَا أَوْلَى النَّاسِ بِعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمْ لَيْسَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَهُ نَبِيٌّ. Which means there is no other prophet between Prophet Isa, Jesus alayhi salam, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah Ta'ala said in the Holy Quran in Surah Maryam, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صُدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. And Allah Ta'ala also said in Surah Al-Anbiya in the Holy Quran, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ رُشْدَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ وَكُنَّا بِهِ عَالِمِينَ. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam is the son of Tariq. His father was named Tariq, also known as Azar. Tariq is the father of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, and he had also another name known as Azar. And he is the descendant of Sam, the son of Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. So he is Ibrahim alayhi salam, the son of Azar, then one of the descendants of Sam, the son of Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. Prophet Nuh had four sons. Sam, Ham, and Yafith were believers, whereas Canaan did not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When all the people died on earth, except those who were on the ship, on the ark, a safina, with Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, and they were about 80. Among them are the three sons of Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. All those other than the three sons of Prophet Nuh did not have any descendants. Only those from the three sons of Nuh alayhi salam descended. So Prophet Ibrahim, he is one of the descendants of Sam, the son of Nuh alayhi salam. He was very known with his generosity, and he used to be called the father of guests. He used to welcome the guests in his house and feed them, and was very generous to them alayhi salam. He was born in Iraq, in a city called Babel, which is Babylon in Iraq. At that time, unfortunately, people were disbelievers, worshipping the idols. They used to worship the seven planets. They made statues for it and started worshipping it, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ تَعَالَى. And there was a king called Nimrod. And Nimrod claimed godhood, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. And he was a tyrant king, unjust ruler. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was born at that time. He was born in Babylon, a city in Iraq. And it has been mentioned that before his birth, a king saw in the dream a fire coming out from the land of Palestine into his territory and burning his properties. He woke up alarmed and he called the fortune tellers to interpret that dream for him. Those fortune tellers told him that a man will come from that land and he will take over your rulership. He will throw you out. What he did, and Nimrod, he advised his soldiers to go to every pregnant woman and to kill her child. And he started doing that, killing the children, the newborn children, because according to his claim, he wanted to save his kingdom from that enemy who is coming from that land. Now the mother of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, when she fell pregnant with Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, she was not a fat lady, she was skinny. And the signs of her pregnancy was not apparent. So they did not know that she was pregnant. And by the time when she was in labor, she went to a cave and she gave birth to her son Ibrahim alayhi salam in the cave. Now she did not take her son Ibrahim alayhi salam back to the city, because she feared that if she took him back to the city, they might kill him. She left him in the cave, and by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah Ta'ala saved Prophet Ibrahim, and he used to get fed by sucking his thumb. By the will of Allah, it was sufficient for him to nourish and to stay alive. And she used to visit him time by time to look after him while he was in the cave. It has been mentioned that Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam remained in the cave for 1 year and 3 months. 15 months in total, he remained in the cave. Subhanallah. sucking his thumb, and Allah Ta'ala made it as a method to nourish in his cave. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was mentioned in the Holy Quran in number of surahs, and he was also mentioned with his nephew Prophet Lut alayhi salam. Prophet Ibrahim was the uncle from the father's side of Prophet Lut alayhi salam. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was a believer since day one of his life. He did not worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah ta'ala indicated in the Holy Quran, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ رُشْدَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ. What is the meaning مِنْ قَبْلِ? مِنْ قَبْلِ literally could mean before. The meaning of مِنْ قَبْلِ, some ulama who explained the ayahs of the Quran said مِنْ قَبْلِ meaning before puberty, before turning adult. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam knew that no one is God except Allah. He had the essence of belief in his heart that no one deserves to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the term min qabl, some ulama said min qabl al-nubuwa, some others said min qabl al-bulugh. So there are two sayings in this regard, min qabl al-nubuwa, meaning before he became a prophet, he was guided. He knew that Allah Ta'ala is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. And some ulama said, even min qabli al-bulugh, before turning adult, he was also guided. He knew that Allah Ta'ala is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. He did not believe in other than al-Islam. He only believed in al-Islam. This is the meaning of Hanifa, the follower of the only acceptable true religion, which is al-Islam. وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And he was not one of the mushrikeen, those who associated partners with Allah. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam saw his father Azar worshipping the idols, and he started calling him to Islam, to leave out worshipping the idols. Unfortunately, his father did not listen to him. And he tried and tried and tried many times explaining to his father that the idols do not deserve to be worshipped. They cannot bring over a harm or a benefit to the human being. Yet he did not listen to him. He was a stubborn person. And Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam kept on asking Allah Azza wa Jal to guide his father. Then Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam received the revelation from Allah Ta'ala telling him that your father is not going to believe. You wanted him to believe in Allah, but Allah Ta'ala willed eternally that your father, O Ibrahim, your father Azar, is not going to believe. Subhanallah. This is by the will of Allah. Allah Ta'ala predestined that the father of his prophet Ibrahim, who was the second best prophet, will not believe in Allah. The same as the uncle of the prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Abu Talib, did not believe in Allah. He loved the prophet, he defended the prophet, he supported the prophet, but he did not believe in him. While he was dying, while he was on his deathbed, the Prophet knew that his uncle is almost passing away, close to death. So he went to him and he invited him to embrace Islam. Then Abu Talib looked at the prominent figures of Quraysh around him, who were around him next to his bed, looking at him, saying, what is his response when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is inviting him to believe in Allah? to leave out worshipping the idols, to embrace Islam. So he looked at him. He looked at the faces of the prominent figures of Quraysh who weren't Muslims. And then he replied to the Prophet, I fear that those people are going to defame me by saying that he left the religion of his grandfathers. So according to him, he said, this does not befit me, that my reputation will be wrecked. And everyone is going to say that I left the religion of my grandfather. Then the Prophet alayhi salat wasalam invited him again and said to him, say it next to my ear. If you do not want to say it loudly so that everyone can hear you, say it next to my ear. Whisper in my ear. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. He was so caring about his uncle sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So he told him, say it, even whisper it in my ear. I will be a witness for you on the day of judgment. He said, no, I'm not going to say it. And he died as an unbeliever. The Prophet was very upset that he wanted his uncle to embrace Islam, to die as Muslim, so that he will be saved from the everlasting, eternal torture in hellfire. But unfortunately, he did not say it. He did not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala said, إِنَّكَ, addressing the Prophet, لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتْ. You cannot create the guidance in the hearts of those whom you invited to Islam. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. You cannot create the guidance in the heart of those whom you invited to embrace Islam. Let us talk now about the story of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam with a Nimrod. When a Nimrod wanted to debate Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he invited him over to his palace, Prophet Ibrahim went to An-Nimrud to invite him, to call him to Islam. An-Nimrud claimed godhood. He used to worship himself, wal-iyazu billah. He used to claim that he was God, An-Nimrud. So the first question An-Nimrud asked Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, who do you worship? Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam said, I worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتِ, the one who sends people to death and the one who brings them back to life. الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتِ. An-Nimrod looked at that and said, I can do that. I can send people to death and bring them back to life. What happened is, he brought two prisoners from the jail. And he ordered one of them to be executed and the second to be set free. So he killed one of them and he freed the other. And he said to Prophet Ibrahim, look at me. أنا أحييت وأمت. I sent him to death and I brought this man back to life. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam had an instant answer by saying to him, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْتِي بِالشَّمْسِ مِنَ الْمَشْرِقِ فَأْتِ بِهَا مِنَ الْمَغْرِبِ. Allah Ta'ala is the one who makes the sun rise from the east and making it setting in the west. Do raise it from the west. And he was refuted instantly. But he looked at Prophet Ibrahim angrily and said to him, I want you to show me how your God revives the dead. Otherwise, I'm going to kill you. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam did not fear An-Nimrod. He was not scared from him. But Prophet Ibrahim, he was so ready and wanted to ask Allah Azza wa Jal to show him how Allah Ta'ala revives the dead. He wanted to see the process of revival. It has been said that he was next to a seashore on the beach, and there was a dead animal. You know, the low tide and high tide. Because of the high tide, the water pushed the dead body inside. The beasts came, scavengers, and eating from it. And because of the low tide, fish might come and eat from it. And then the birds will come over and eat from it. Three types of creatures are eating from the same dead body. Then this is when Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam asked Allah Ta'ala to show him how he revives the dead. Prophet Ibrahim was not doubtful about the will of Allah and the power of Allah. He knew that Allah Ta'ala has power and he is able, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to bring the dead alive again, to the life again. He did not say, "Oh Allah, are you able to revive the dead?" But what Allah Ta'ala said in the Quran, قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي كَيْفَ تُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. Oh Allah, show me how you revive the dead. He did not say, "Oh Allah, are you able to revive the dead?" He was not doubtful about the power of Allah to revive the dead. He only said, "Rabbi arini," show me how you revive the dead. Allah Ta'ala ordered him to bring four types of birds: a pigeon, a rooster, a crow, and a peacock. Four birds, four different types of birds. And then Allah Ta'ala ordered him to slaughter them and to chop the head off the body, then to cut them down into small pieces. Keep the heads with you away and mix the parts of the four bodies together, feather with feather, pieces of flesh. Mix this strange mixture together. Four bodies, except the heads, are getting cut into tiny pieces, then mixed. Then he was ordered to divide this strange mixture on four mountains. And some ulama said seven mountains. So he distributed the mixture on number of mountains. Then he stood in a place where the mountains were around him. And he was ordered to call upon the birds. So he stood and he called upon the birds, which were dead. Dead birds. The body got chopped into small pieces, mixed together. The heads were in his hand. And he called upon the dead birds. By the will of Allah, after calling the dead birds, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam saw the parts are getting reassembled again, according to what it were before. So the parts of peacock getting reassembled again as peacock without head, the rooster, the crow, and the pigeon. The bodies returned back to where it was before slaughtering it, except for the heads. Where did he keep the heads? In his hand. Then he called upon them again, and they started walking with no heads. by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The peacock walked to him, the crow, the pigeon, they all came to him alayhi salam, and they stood before him with no heads. Now it is time to place the heads on the right bodies. When Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam wanted to place the head of the rooster on the pigeon, it did not attach until he placed it on the right body and it became attached back again to the normal status by the will of Allah. So he placed the right heads on the right bodies by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then what happened next? And Nimrod became very furious and angry. Then he called upon Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam to bring over his soldiers. He want him to have a fight with him. He said, "Ijma' jumu'aka wa ajma'u jumu'i." Ask your supporters and soldiers to come over, and I will ask the army to come over to have combat. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was supported from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Prophet Ibrahim, he does not need to ask Allah Azza wa Jal to support him by bringing the angels to him so that he will form an army in order to fight An-Nimrud. Allah Ta'ala sent a small mosquito which entered from the nose of the Nimrud into his brain. So this small opening, which is the nose opening, was big enough for the mosquito to enter from it and to land on his brain. And he started having a headache, a migraine. It was so painful. He could not sleep. He could not have a rest. He could not eat. A very severe migraine. Time had passed, hours and days, while he was suffering, while he was in agony, suffering from this pain, unbearable pain, to the extent that he asked those who are helping him in the palace, "Please come over, bring me medicine, doctors." They could not cure him from this migraine. To the extent that he said to them, "Hit me on the head. Perhaps this will relieve me from this migraine." And they started hitting him on the head with shoes, with piece of food and other things. He is not relieved from his pain. Time had passed. Few months had passed. Years had passed while he's suffering from this continuous migraine. Constant one, 24/7, no relief. For how many years he get tortured? Some ulama said, for 400 years, 400 years, this Nimrod is getting tortured. Constant pain for 400 years, non-stop. Until he passed away. For 400 years, he was getting tortured. And he became an example to those who associated partners with Allah. Look at him. He claimed that he is God. He called people to worship him, but he was not able to help himself from this agony, to save himself from this migraine. He was humiliated. Allah Ta'ala destroyed him in this dunya, and he is suffering from the everlasting torture of the hereafter in hell. He will not be relieved from the torture in the hereafter, in Jahannam. This is his final place. That was brief about the story of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam with the birds and the Nimrod. And there are a number of stories, inshallah. I will be talking about it, inshallah, next week, talking about when he was thrown into the huge fire, when he was saved from it, and when his wife Sarah entered the land of Egypt, when she met Al-Jabbar, that king, and some other also benefits will be mentioned, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Barakallahu feekum. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the torture in the grave and in the hereafter, and to admit us to paradise without punishment. And Allah ta'ala knows best.